Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to install the latest version of Angular, that is Angular version 18, on Windows operating system. And after that, I am also going to show you how you can easily create a simple Hello World Angular project and how to run that on our browser. So do watch the video till the end. I can guarantee if you watch the video till the end, you will be learning a lot of new things. And if you still face any issues in middle, you can always comment in your comment sections. I'll try my best to help you. Now to install latest version of Angular, first thing that you need to have is Node.js. For that, I have already made a detailed video about how to install Node.js. You can follow that detailed video. So what you need to do basically is you need to go to favorite browser and then you need to just simply type Node.js. And you will land it over to the official site of Node.js. So you need to use this link. And here you can switch to download tab. So this is currently the interface of Node.js. So here you need to switch to this pre-built installer and you will get this download button. So you need to click on this download button and then you need to install your Node.js. Right. So if I go to search and just simply type cmd to open our command prompt. And now if I just simply type node space dash dash version and hit enter, you can see that our latest version of Node.js, that is LTS version 20.13.1, is successfully installed. So always I recommend you to download LTS version. Alright, for Angular also you'll need LTS version. So download your node and then install that. Once you have node, next thing that you will need is Visual Studio Code. So again, for that also I have made a detailed video. I'll still show you about how to install that. So you need to download this Visual Studio. So you can see it is right, it started downloading. And once when it get downloaded, you need to just simply click on that installer to install our Visual Studio Code. So accept the license agreement, click on next. So this is where our Visual Studio code is going to be installed. Totally fine, just simply click on next. So Visual Studio Code folder they're going to create, click on next. And here I am going to select all these different options so that automatically they're going to set the path along with desktop shortcut. And also on right clicking, we'll get this option called open with code. That's a very useful feature, I must say. So always check each and everything and click on next. So ready to be installed, click on install and there you go. So preparing to install, our Visual Studio is rightly started installing. Let's wait for a couple of minutes. And there you go. You can see that our Visual Studio is successfully installed along with desktop shortcut is also created over here. So once you have Node and Visual Studio Code, now it's time to install Angular. So now let's first click on finish. So that's going to open Visual Studio Code. I'll close this for now. So once you have both these two software, Node.js and Visual Studio Code, so now you need to run this command called npm install space dash g /angular/cli. That's all. So dash g basically means globally you are installing Angular, and cli basically means command line interface. So just simply hit enter and it's going to start fetching all the files from internet and going to install it locally on your system, the latest version of Angular. Alright, so it's going to take some time, maybe a couple of minutes. So you need to have active internet connection right throughout this installation. And once when again Angular gets done, I'm going to again come back to this video. Yeah. So welcome back. And now you can clearly see that our Angular is successfully installed. So if you see this similar type of prompt, then all that basically mean is your Angular is successfully installed. So to verify whether it is properly installed or not, you need to just simply type ng space dash dash version and hit enter. And that's going to show you that latest version of Angular, that is version 18.01, is successfully shown over here. So if you see this similar type of prompt, then all that basically mean is your Angular is successfully installed. All right. So once your Angular get installed, it's time to create a new project. So for that, what I'm going to do is, first I'm going to close this command prompt. I'm going to create a new folder over here. So I'm going to name that folder as, Angular practice. And within this folder, I'm going to open command prompt. So I'll just simply type cmd and that's going to open our command prompt right at this location. Alright, and now to create a new Angular project, you need to just simply type ng space new and then your application name. So let's give the application name as, you know, my demo app. Alright, you should be giving your own project name. So, you know, just simply type this much and then it's going to show you this prompt. So here it is asking basically whether you'd like to send anonymously your users' data to Google. That will help to improve its performance and all. So you can always, you know, send data, or else you can just simply give no, hit enter. And then it is asking that what type of style sheet you want, whether you want like the traditional CSS type of style sheet or SAS or less. So you can just, you know, click on that down key arrow on your keyboard to navigate to all these different options. So I'll keep the traditional CSS only. I'll hit enter. And now it is asking whether you like to enable your server side rendering or static site generation. So it totally depends upon you and your project, what type of project you want. For now, I'm going to keep it simple. So I'll just give N. And it's going to start creating our Angular project. So you can see it is actually started creating that. Alright. So again, you need to have active internet connection. So it's going to fetch some of the files from internet, and then it's going to create our Angular project. So let's wait for a couple of minutes again. So welcome back. So now you can clearly see that our project is successfully created. So let's go inside our project. So just simply type, you know, cd your project name, which is my demo app. So just hit enter and we are inside my demo app. And now if we just simply type code space dot and hit enter, that's going to open our Visual Studio Code, you know, right after opening this project. So yes, I trust the authors. So you can see if you just simply type this code, like code dot on command prompt, that's going to open your project, you know, right at your Visual Studio Code. All right. So now if you maximize this, and if you go to this Explorer and click on this triple dot, and then you enable this npm script, so just simply click on that. So that's going to open npm scripts over here. So if you expand this, and if you click on this start, that is basically ng serve. So if you click on this run button, immediately you'll be seeing that it is started executing this task ng serve. So once when it gets builded, it's going to automatically show you one URL. So you can see this URL it is showing on localhost 4200. Our site is up and running. So just, you know, simply click on that and then click on follow link. So when you click on that, it's going to redirect to your browser. So where our latest version of Angular, that is Angular 18 version, is up and running on our localhost 4200. All right. So congratulations, your app is running. So if you go to your code and if you open this package.json file, you can see that our latest version of Angular, that is 18, we have successfully installed, and our project is also using latest version of Angular 18. And if you expand your src folder, and we have this index.html, and if you expand our app, you'll get, you know, all these different files. So let's open our app.component. So you can see have all these things over here, right? So what I'm going to do is, within our main class, I'm going to remove all the different stuff. So only main tag I'm going to keep, and I'm going to remove all the different stuff from here. So I'll just simply hit delete, and I'm going to give a p tag, and within p tag I'm going to write hello world over here. And after that, if I just simply save this, you can see that our project is again successfully builded. So now if I again go to browser, you can see that all the things are totally wiped off and only hello world it is showing only on our browser, right? So in this way you can, you know, easily remove all the stuff and you can start, you know, creating your project, right? So that's basically all about this video. Hope these videos are really helping you. Please do like, share and subscribe. I have started Geeky Syntax channel, so here regularly I'm posting coding related videos. So please do subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel. Along with, if you're interested, you can also subscribe our Geeky Script blogging channel. And also I have posted one video on how to create a free e-commerce store. So if you're interested, you can also watch this entire 50-minute video. So that will help you to learn about WordPress, e-commerce, you know, how to use WooCommerce to create a e-commerce website. So all these different things you'll be learning if you watch this tutorial. So yeah, that's pretty much all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.